Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and this is bloody amazing. This is the Epiphone Inspired By Gibson Les Paul Special. Now I've got to say, this has been on the wall here at the Newcastle branch of PMT for a little while now, and I just thought it was a Gibson. I've already got a video on the Gibson Les Paul Special, but not on the Inspired By Gibson Epiphone one. Out of all of them, I think this looks the most Gibson-y just because it's a TV yellow, and you never see Epiphones in TV yellow. I've already got a video of the Les Paul Jr. and the other Inspired By Gibsons on the channel. I'll link a few below, but I've now done one on this, and it delivers on all counts of a Les Paul Special. Essentially, a Les Paul Jr. with a neck pickup and the Les Paul configurations. It's a bit thinner than you think, and if you think that you've played Epiphone Les Paul Specials with P90s in before, you might as well, and that's great, they're great guitars, but you've never played one like this. You've never played one as close to the real deal as this, and it certainly doesn't break the bank. You're hearing this glorious guitar through 2 SEC cables into a Daddario chromatic tuner, into a Marshall 1987 X Plexi head, because why not? It's a Les Paul Jr. and into a Marshall, it sounds fantastic. Whether it be a tiny Marshall or a big Marshall. I'm attenuating it and using the two notes Torpedo Captor X to emulate a 4x12 cab, XLR out of that into your ears. I'm not micing it up, I'm just using this 1960 AV cab to hear it myself. Now the specs. It's exactly what we expect for a Les Paul Special. Mahogany body, beautiful set mahogany neck, and it's a 50s profile. So it's a chunky lass, but not as chunky as like the custom shop 50s, because the original 50s Les Paul Specials were incredibly big necks. So much so people didn't really enjoy playing them. They were quite unique, let's say. So these days, Epiphone and Gibson on the run-of-the-mill specials have a chunky neck, but it's not too chunky. It will suit you if you play blues, if you play funk, if you play rock and roll. It'll be comfy regardless, it's just a bit chunkier. Up at the headstock, you'll see the new Inspired By Gibson Epiphone headstock, more akin to a Gibson. It's actually the old Kalamazoo headstock. Lovely little touch, vintage style buttons here as well. Graftech new bone nut going down a beautiful Indian laurel fingerboard, adorned with 22 medium jumbo frets, and the radius itself is 12 inch, so a very familiar Gibson fingerboard radius on an otherwise chunky neck. The whole thing's bound as well for the price. This is just stellar. Black 5-ply pickguard, wraparound tailpiece with a lightning bolt, compensated design to help with intonation. You've also got the two little grub screws down the back. P90 Pro Epiphone pickups, it delivers that classic Gibson P90 growl, but it's an Epiphone. CTS pots, so only the best of the best, with orange drop capacitors. I really love what Gibson are doing with Epiphone at the minute. They're making them just little carbon copies as the originals. However, it's polyurethane lacquer as opposed to nitro to help with the cost, and it's made overseas, but it's just there. The vibe is there, the tone is there, and the tone's good. The tone's good. I love these Junior Special guitars because they're the kind of guitars that the harder you hit, the better the sound. Joy to play. So the neck pickup has a beautiful, and the bridge pickup. Neck and the bridge pickup both have treble bleed roll off things, witchcraft in the controls, which means when you turn the volume down, it retains that high end. Thank you. The bite you get from a single coil is just remarkable. P90. They clean up beautifully as well, so that's obviously quite a dirty tone. The lighter you pick, the more, the cleaner it gets and the more dynamic it gets. When you roll the volume down, that to remember, P90s were invented by Gibson in the 40s. These were the first ever pickups, and jazz was a big thing back then, so just roll the bridge pickup down. Neck pickup even. That's how I play jazz. Of P90 raunchiness there, because they are still single coils, and they have, you have got to fight with them. They make a lot of noise, especially when there's more distortion. They kind of fight with you, but they're instruments in themselves, and you've got to work with it to create some of the most badass sounds you'll ever hear with a P90. I think, ladies and gents, that's all the sight specs and sounds I can get out of the amazing Epiphone Inspired by Gibson Les Paul Special. I adore this thing. I've always wanted one of these, and I forgot how cheap they were. Click the link in the description box to check the price of this and comment down below your favourite P90 tone. Let's go for P90 tone this week. I think this is a gorgeous thing, and you have to try one for yourselves at a PMT store. It'll blow you away just like it did me. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Les Paul Special by the fine folk at Epiphone, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call us one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of this with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.